Yesterday we started with the social engineering part, so we just discussed some of the introductory things related to the topic, and I have told about the particular impacts of social engineering, what was the history, something like that, and then we progressed with some of the categories. Okay, so we discussed about the human based social engineering like impersonation, then we moved on to the computer based social engineering, so that we will look from today onwards, and then we will just try to sum up that in case of what are the countermeasures, how you can stop this social engineering. Okay, if you want to be, and if you're very aware about this fact, so we'll see some of the things related to that. Okay, so that will be the outline for today's presentation, and in the end we will taking a short demo related to a particular tool that is inbuilt, okay, in Kali Linux, and somewhere also you can download through the GitHub link that I will show you, and you can just find it out that how this particular credentials can be taken out. Okay, so that is a short demo, but there are too many other things which you can just go around, because this is a huge research topic, and you can just explore more and more. So social engineering is more or less towards the awareness factor. That means you have to be very aware about the things, so that we will be covering in this session. Okay, so I think so I should start with where I have left yesterday. So this was the end that we were discussing yesterday, like computer based social engineering, and I've told you something about the particular things related to computer based social engineering, like how this particular happens by using the desktops like pop-up windows, hoax letters, chain letters, spam emails, and the chat messenger. So we have discussed this yesterday, and earlier, moving on to this computer-based social engineering, we have discussed something related to the human-based social engineering, where a person can be in contact directly, or he can be on contact related to some of the other communication medium. Okay, so we have discussed this particular thing, but we will take our discussion further from this way, why particularly we are using. So the second thing that we just wanted to discuss over here, that computer-based social engineering, in which there is a topic or a term comes into picture, like which is phishing, and this is more or less very common to everybody who is just working on internet these days. So I will just let you know an introductory thing related to what phishing is. So it's basically a technique in which you can call like a fake email, which looks like as a legitimate email is sent to a target host, and when I think so somebody is on the chat. Okay, so just to describe what phishing is, so I just talking about the phishing, it's just a technique which you know, and in which a particular fake email looks like exactly a legitimate email, and it is basically sent to the target host, and when the recipient opens the particular link, he is like enticed for providing information. And typically the readers are redirected to the fake web page, what you call that resembles an official website. Okay. And the user provides all sensitive information to a fake website, believing it is an official website because of its resemblance to the exact, what you call as the legitimate website. Okay. So this is what phishing is all about. And it is very common these days. People are getting too many illegitimate emails. Okay. Which basically, or which falsely claim to be legitimate site attempts. And basically the main goal of doing all these particular emails is to acquire users' personal information, okay, or the account information. Okay, so this is pretty much common, and spamming is basically done these days. Okay, so phishing is also a part of this. So phishing emails basically pops up, okay, and it basically redirects you to fake web pages, okay, of mimicking trustworthy sites, and they basically ask you to submit your personal information, and by anyhow you basically get convinced and you just submit your personal information over there. Okay, but these are the fake, or what you call as the illegitimate sites. Okay, so this is the part of phishing that we're talking about, and social engineering attacks are basically to target the particular audience, and before being target, as I've told you yesterday also, this is the first phase where you want to gather some information. So still now we are talking about how to gather this information. So this is computer-based social engineering, and phishing is one of the attempt actually. Okay. So this is just an example how this can happen. So phishing is a part from which the computer-based social engineering attacks can be done. Okay. So this is very common and pretty much known to everybody who is working on these days in the internet and reading some of the news related to these issues. Okay. So there is another term that comes into picture from where these particular social engineering attacks are basically being triggered, and what you call as spear phishing. And it is basically a type of phishing which is focused on a target. Okay. Focused on a target means you are basically directed, or you are just targeting a particular specific individual within an organization. And this is a targeted phishing attack on an individual. And basically, what you call as spear phishing generates a high response rate as compared to the random phishing attack. And what does it means actually? Iska kya matlab hai ki it basically generates high response attack. That means because you are just targeting a particular individual. Okay, so you just track the entire history and you have the entire social engineering content related to a specific person. Okay, or what you call as a small group of people. All, say for example, there are 10 people who are working focusedly on your particular project, which is of national importance. Okay, like aapka group of people hai, which is basically targeting a kind of a project actually. And you just target that particular audience. Okay, so you just this kind of phishing attack will be having a higher response rate because you tracked each and every event, each and every history, each and every activity of that particular group. Okay, so phishing is something which is very belonging to a very normal thing that basically is not targeting a specific individual or a group of people, but the spear phishing basically targets some amount of people, okay, and which are focused to a certain amount of work, and you just want their information only, okay. So this is what spear phishing is called, and on the slide also you can see it's basically a direct targeted phishing attack, which basically aimed at a specific individual, okay. It can be a specific individual or it can be 5 to 10 people also, depending on what kind of information you want or what kind of project work they are basically doing. If it is of national importance, then state players, state nations are basically into these kind of activities to get that information. Okay, so this is another kind of computer-based social engineering attack, and this is the second category. So there is something computer-based social engineering, like publishing some what you call as malicious applications, and these things are very much in common these days. And what this actually means, I can just tell you, and this is not exactly what you call as the computer-based social engineering. It's basically mobile-based, what you call as mobile-based social engineering. And what it is actually mean, I have written wrongly over here, like it is computer-based, but we will call it as the mobile-based social engineering. And what happens in this, it is a technique by publishing malicious application on application store to be available, okay, for download on a large scale. Okay, so these malicious applications are normally a replica or a similar copy of a popular application. Okay, so aap ek bilkul exact copy banate hain, and basically you publish on the application store for the larger audience. Okay, for example, what you call as an attacker may develop a malicious application for any social media application, what you call as like Facebook. Okay, but this is just an example. The user, instead of downloading an official application, may accidentally or intentionally download this third party malicious application. Okay, basically there were two applications, there was an original application, but anyhow aapne koi fake copy generate kari and it is available for a larger audience on the Play Store. So anyhow, कोई इंटेंशनली कोई अनइंटेंशनली इसको डाउनलोड कर सकता है, एंड ऑब्वियसली व्हेन अ यूजर साइंस इन, द मलिशियस एप्लीकेशन विल सेंड द लॉगिन क्रेडेंशियल्स टू द रिमोट सर्वर कंट्रोल्ड बाय द अटैकर. ओके, सो दिस व्हाट हैपेंस बेसिकली ओवर हियर. सो दिस इज पब्लिशिंग अ मलिशियस एप्लीकेशन. सो पब्लिशिंग मीन्स दैट यू आर जस्ट क्रिएटिंग अ रेप्लिका और अ सिमिलर कॉपी ऑफ अ लेजिटिमेट और अ पॉपुलर एप्लीकेशन. ओके, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर इज एन एप्लीकेशन विच हैव 10 million, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यूजर्स, and accountability is there. But anyhow, someone generates or some attacker generates a replica or an exact copy of that and just publish on the Play Store or some of the other store for a larger audience. And anyhow, people just get them download those, that application instead of the original one. Okay, so that is the main case. and when the particular user will be just logging into those into that replica, then that particular credentials will be just sent to a particular attacker server rather being on the original site. Okay, so this is another example, but this is not computer based. I'm just repeating it. This is just a kind of a mobile based social engineering. By mistake, I have just mentioned this is computer based, but this is an example more or less related to the mobile based social engineering. Okay, that is the third category. Yesterday, I have discussed there were three categories. Last time, maine aapko bataya tha. The first was the human based social engineering, in which we talked about some impersonation. Second one was, I think so, you just remember, and we started from there, computer based social engineering. Okay, जिसमें हमने आपको phishing, and second term was the spear phishing. Okay, on third category, or this is the mobile based. Okay, so on the other slide I have has a heading as mobile based social engineering. So this is the third category, and there is another example related to this mobile based social engineering apart from what we are seeing in the last slide, like publishing malicious apps. There is another term, repackaging of the legitimate apps. Okay, so repackaging means, people might have heard, this is also a very common term these days, who have encountered these kind of social engineering attacks. Like what you can say is, it's another technique where a repacking a legitimate application with a malware. Okay, so there is already an original or a legitimate application, but people or the attacker, what are they doing? They are basically repacking it with a malware. So original application ke saath unhone kuch malware ko repack kiya. Okay, pack kar diya gaya. So ek naya aapke paas application hai, but that will be a malicious thing. Okay, so what attacker initially downloads a popular, most in demand application from the application store, and typically what they do, typically games and antiviruses and the other softwares are most commonly used. So attacker basically usi ko target karte hain, and attacker repackages these kind of applications which are very much in demand. Okay, so they, what they do, they basically repack the application with the malware, and they again upload it to the third party store. Okay, so legitimate application ke sath malware ko combine karke fir se ek naya application banaya, and that particular application is again uploaded onto a Play Store or something like that, or a third party store, what you call as, and it is available for a larger audience. Now what happens, the user may not be aware of the availability of this particular application on the application store and get a link for free download, okay, of a paid application. Application aapki paid thi, say for example, but attacker kya karta hai, it basically, he or she basically sends a kind of a link saying that this is a free application version of this particular application, and now you can download it. So it is freely available. So ek bar aapke mann mein second thought aayega, oh, I am getting it as a free one. Okay, so aap usko download karenge, and as soon as you get basically download it, it will be containing a malware also. So it is not the clean application, it is a malicious application. So instead of downloading from an official application from a trusted store, a user accidentally or intentionally downloads this repacked application from the third party store. Okay, so there are other stores available. When a user signs in, and obviously the malicious application will send this login credentials to the remote server, which is controlled by the attacker. Okay, so this is a pictorial diagram that I was talking about. So what happens in the entire channel that I have told you, what happens in kind of a repackaging of these legitimate application. So this basically, they try to repack it along with the available original application. Okay, and they basically just put it on the third party store, from where basically the user tries to download it. Okay, or they basically send a kind of a free link to the larger audience, and the application is basically paid. तो पेड एप्लीकेशन अगर आपको फ्री में मिलेगी तो ऑब्वियसली यू विल थिंक, ओ आई एम गेटिंग इट एज अ फ्री, सो ऑब्वियसली आई विल ट्राई टू डाउनलोड इट. ओ एज सून एज यू डाउनलोड इट ऑन द पर्टिकुलर बेयर मशीन, सो इट विल बी हैविंग अ काइंड ऑफ मैलवेयर ऑन टू इट. ओके, सो दिस इज द थर्ड कैटेगरी और अनदर कैटेगरी ऑफ मोबाइल बेस्ड सोशल इंजीनियर्ड अटैक्स. ओके, सो यू कैन सी ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर पिक्टोरियल डायग्राम. सो व्हाट हैपेंस,
हेलो हेलो संजय जी, कोई प्रॉब्लम आ गई क्या? अरे
हेलो, आई थिंक
जी हाँ
यू
जी,
डिसकनेक्टेड एनी हो. सॉरी फॉर द इंटरप्शन. सो आई वॉज ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर मोबाइल बेस्ड एप्लीकेशन एंड रीपैकेजिंग ऑफ दीज लेजिटिमेट एप्लीकेशंस. ओके, सो आई हैव जस्ट कवर्ड दिस इन केस आई मिस दैट, सो आई कैन जस्ट टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट दिस एज वेल. ओके, सो रीपैकेजिंग इज बेसिकली वॉट यू आर कॉलिंग एज. एक आपके पास ऑथेंटिक एप्लीकेशन थी एंड यू बेसिकली जस्ट रीपैक दैट एप्लीकेशन बाय सम ऑफ द मैलवेयर. ओके, एंड एनी हाउ it is available on any of the third party application store and from where these people basically can download all these things. Okay, so another category is what do you call as mobile based social engineering, in which we have fake security applications. Okay, so this is another category these days which is very much prominent actually. Like this is similar to the above technique. An attacker can may develop a fake security application. Okay, so this security application may be downloaded by a pop-up window. Okay, when the user is browsing a website on internet or is just basically surfing actually. Okay, so this is another kind of category of mobile based social engineering. Okay, so what happens basically, the attacker first try to infect the victim or a target personal computer or a desktop machine, and then he can just try to logs on into his or her personal information or to his banking website or to his particular bank account. You can just see it on this particular slide. And then what happens? Malware in this particular pops up a message telling that particular victim or the target to just download an application. Okay. And download that application either onto his system or to on his particular phone by sending him some of the message. Okay, and what happens, the victim thinks that okay, this is a kind of a message which is relevant to me, and he downloads that particular application onto his or her phone. Okay, now what happens, the attacker can access this kind of second authentication factor, which these days you call as 2F factor authentication or two factor authentication, and basically this, and he sent that particular victim from the bank via the SMS. Okay, so this is the entire scenario what that happens actually in the fake security application. But this is similar to the above technique that we were discussing. Okay, so an attacker can develop a fake security application. So the application is which is available on a third party store is a fake one. Okay, and this security application can be downloaded by a pop-up window which basically generates when you surf on the net. Okay, so when जब आप बहुत सारे वेबसाइट्स पे सर्फ करते हो ऑन द इंटरनेट, सो देयर इज अ हाई प्रोबेबिलिटी कि आपको साइड विंडोज के ऊपर पॉपअप्स आएंगे जिसमें कुछ लिंक्स हो सकते हैं, एंड दे बेसिकली कैन आस्क यू टू डाउनलोड समथिंग. ओके, एंड फर्स्टली व्हेन यू जस्ट एज सून एज यू जस्ट क्लिक ऑन टू दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉपअप विंडो मैसेज, व्हाट हैपेंस, एन एप्लीकेशन गेट डाउनलोडेड. ओके, और वो आपके फोन पे भी डाउनलोड हो सकती है. ओके, एंड देन what happens, it may contain a malware and can send a kind of a message, okay, which has this particular link. Okay, so victim basically download these malicious application on his her phone, and now what happens, ki attacker ke paas pura access hai. Access kiske liye hai? Aapki second authentication factor ke is kya contain karta, it can contain that particular one time passwords as well. Okay, so he can easily use that window. Okay, so this is what is you call as a fake security application using this mobile based social engineering. Okay, so I hope so this is something clear, because it is same more or less with this repackaging legitimate. Isme bhi aap malware ko introduce kar rahe hain, induce kar rahe hain ek legitimate application ke sath, aur isme bhi aapke paas ek exact security application hai, lekin aapne usme kya kiya hai, kisi bhi tarah se usko fake kara hai aur usko available kiya hai larger audience ke liye. और किस तरह से वो डाउनलोड कर रहे हैं, बाय यूजिंग समथिंग पॉपअप विंडोज, समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो ऑन द पिक्चर आल्सो यू कैन सी इन द फर्स्ट पॉइंट देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर अटैकर व्हिच कैन इन्फेक्ट द यूजर्स और द यूजर डेस्कटॉप मशीन, एंड देन व्हाट हैपेंस, ही जस्ट बेसिकली अपलोड्स द मलिशियस एप्लीकेशन ऑनटू द एप्लीकेशन स्टोर, एंड देन यूजर लॉग्स ऑन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर बैंक अकाउंट, पॉपअप अ मैसेज. ओके, एंड ही और शी बेसिकली डाउनलोड्स एन एप्लीकेशन ऑनटू हर फोन. ओके, so this is the basic scenario behind fake this fake security application based or mobile based social engineering. Okay, so these are two scenarios what we are talking about. Now also I can just wanted to tell you over here that there, if you have heard about, there is also an insider attack. Okay, have you heard about this? This is not related to anything else, but over here the social engineering attacks can be easily done by the insiders as well who are working into an organization. And if you have heard about, near about, the statistics says that 30% to 40% of the attacks that are happening in an organization are basically related to the insiders only. Okay, क्योंकि उनके पास आपकी premises की, आपकी organizations की बहुत ज्यादा जानकारी है. Okay, and why they are doing so, they can be disgruntled employees. Disgruntled employees मतलब आप, हो सकता है they are not mentally fit. Okay, they have some of the grudges related or grievances related to an organization, so they can share those particular details. Okay, so I can just tell something in detail about these insiders attack and how these insider attacks are basically related to this social engineering attacks. Okay, so I will just wanted to say that social engineering is not all about the third person gathering information about your organization. It may be an insider, or what you can say, an employee of your organization having privileges or not spying on your organization for malicious intentions. An insider attack is those, is that attack which basically is conducted by these insiders who are working in the organization, and these insiders may be supported by the competitor of an organization. Wo aapke competitors bhi ho sakte hain. A competitor may support a person in your organization for revealing such sensitive information and secrets. So you have to be very aware of that. And this is something other than spying. Okay, insider may have the intention of taking some revenge. Okay, pehla aisa kuch ho sakta hai ki wo aapse badla lena chahe, which is called as revenge. A disgruntled person in an organization may compromise the confidential and sensitive information to take revenge. Okay, so what we are calling as an employee to be maybe disgruntled person when he is not satisfied with the management. Aapke management se satisfied nahi hai, that is why he or she can share the information. And you have heard too many things in the news. Last year also, a particular well-known scientist who are working on a particular kind of a project related to national security, and he was found indulged in these kind of activities, if you heard about that. Okay, and he just got into imprisonment from the Nagpur. So is tarah ke bahut sare aapke paas examples hain. Okay, so he can be trouble facing him from the organization, he might have got the demotion, okay, from the higher management. So there are too many things. So insider attacks can also lead to these social engineering attacks. Okay, so there are other categories also. Okay, so broad categories that we discussed are the human based, computer based, mobile based. And the mobile based, today we have talked about ki किस तरह से आप जो लेजिटिमेट एप्लीकेशंस हैं उनको आप फेक करेंगे, और फेक करने के साथ किस तरह से लार्जर ऑडियंस की तरफ जाएंगे ताकि उस इजीली कन्विंस हो जाएं, कन्विंस होने के बाद उसको डाउनलोड करें. उसके साथ कुछ आपके पास मैलवेयर्स होंगे जो कि आपके सिस्टम या आपके फोन पे डाउनलोड हो सकते हैं, एंड दे कैन जस्ट इंटरसेप्ट इन द कम्युनिकेशन. ओके, सो दीज आर द टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स एक्चुअली. ओके, सो दीज वर द कैटेगरीज एंड समथिंग रिलेटेड टू सोशल नेटवर्किंग. सो ऑल्सो this is a common phenomenon happening this day, these days, impersonation on social networking site. Yesterday humne baat kari thi ki impersonation kya hota hai, lekin social engineering through impersonation on social networking sites kaise hota hai, to wo bhi aaj hum aapko thoda sa batayenge. To uske liye bhi aap dekh sakte ho, like impersonation on social networking site is very popular. And what you call it is very easy and interesting. Like the malicious user gathers personal information of a target from different sources, mostly from the social networking sites. Mostly 60 to 70% people jo aaj kaam kar rahe hain, everybody has or his or her account on Facebook, Twitter. Obviously he was following some of the videos, posting some of the videos on any of the social networking site. On YouTube platforms, he or she will be having a LinkedIn account and whatnot. Okay, so gathered information includes full name. Obviously, we can get the full name. Recent profile picture मिल जाएगी आपको. Date of birth मिल सकता है. Residential address, email address, contact details, what do you call as professional details, educational details, and as much as he can. Okay, क्योंकि एक person इन सभी social networking sites पे available हो सकता है, और किसी भी तरह से अगर आपने profile को lock नहीं कर रखा, you haven't used the privacy settings and something else, then obviously you can just get these kind of information. उसका नाम, उसका recent profile picture, whatever. Okay, date of birth, residential address, an email address, contact details, professional details, education details. Okay, so this is the basic information that we can get. So this is the first phase. Now, what happens? Like after gathering the information about a target, the attacker creates an account that is exactly the same with the account on the social networking site. So itni sari information lene ke baad, wo exactly waisa account banane ki koshish karega. Okay. So the investigate too much, बहुत ज्यादा जानकारी नहीं लेंगे. When they get a friend request and when they find accurate information, सबने information पढ़ी and they just find हाँ information ठीक है, they will definitely accept the request. Okay, so this usually happens with people. You have to be very careful. And once the attacker joined the social media group, when a user shares his or her personal and organizational information, he will get updates from the groups. Okay, so uske paas updates aane lagenge. Jaise maan lijiye koi ek organization ka group tha, maine request bheji fake app account se, mere ko ek kar liya gaya, aur us group mein bahut important information agar share hui to try to use the privacy and the other security settings which are given on either on the Facebook, YouTube, and if you have read yesterday, I have told you about Twitter bhi aapka jo use aap kar rahe hain wo bhi safe nahi hai. Ek bahut well known people jo hain like Barack Obama, Elon Musk, unke Twitter accounts ko bhi aap seki kis tarah se fake kiya gaya, and they just asked for some of the ransoms to be deposited. Okay, so this is a kind of social engineering attack what Twitter claimed about. Okay, so ये तो कल और परसों की ही news है. So you can this आप देख सकते हैं कि nobody is safe actually. Nothing is 100% secure. So you have to be very careful if you are having all these kind of and using these social networking sites. Okay, because बहुत सारे information आप उसपे share करते हैं. So you have to be pretty much careful about this. Okay. This is I talked about in this slide as well, like what is social engineering on Facebook. So I will not be getting into much detail about this. I have told you like attacker can create a fake user group, okay, which is basically identified as employees of, okay. So I'm not getting into this again. This is same what we talked on the last slide, okay. So this is the risk of the social engineering to the corporate network, okay. So corporate networks is what we call as the organizational networks also. And over here, I can just tell you like a social networking site is not secured enough as a corporate network secures the authentication, identification, and authorization of an employee. Okay, accessing the resources. And the major risk is of social networking is its vulnerability in the authentication. Okay, and what happens, an attacker may easily manipulate the security authentication and can create a fake account to access that information. Okay, so this can easily happen. And what happens actually also, if you have heard about like an employee while communicating on social networking may not take care of some sensitive information, any employee may accidentally and intentionally reveal the information which may be helpful for the one he is in communication with, okay, or the third person monitoring his conversation. It requires a need for very strong policy against data leakage. Okay, so aap bahut sari corporate networks mein agar aap dekhenge, multinational companies mein jahan pe ye aapki social networking sites ban hoti hain, okay, most of the things what we have encountered, but still In many of the places, people, what happens, they just open a Facebook account on one of the particular tab, and on the other tab, they are doing their work. Okay, so they are chatting to a particular person, and then they are doing something or the other thing of their particular work. तो ऐसा होता है, एक टैब पे आपका फेसबुक या कोई भी सोशल नेटवर्किंग प्लेटफॉर्म खुला है और दूसरे पे आप कुछ भी कर रहे हैं, तो ये ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए. ओके, दिस इज अ मेजर रिस्क. एंड व्हाट इज द मेजर रिस्क? इज इट्स वल्नरेबिलिटी इन ऑथेंटिकेशन. एन अटैकर मे इजिली मैनिपुलेट द सिक्योरिटी ऑथेंटिकेशन एंड क्रिएट अ फेक अकाउंट, ओके, टू एक्सेस दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन. और सबसे दूसरी बात जो है, जो मैं आपसे बता रहा हूँ, दैट इज एन एम्प्लॉय वाइल कम्युनिकेटिंग ऑन सोशल नेटवर्किंग ऑन वन टैब में एक्सीडेंटली, गलती से भी हो सकता है कि कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन ऐसी हो जो वो कट कॉपी पेस्ट कर रहा हो और अचानक से उसके पास चली गई, एंड दिस इज डन अननोइंगली, ओके, अनइंटेंशनली, बट वो ऐसी इन्फॉर्मेशन चीज जो कि थर्ड पर्सन उसको कैसे भी यूज कर सकता. तो दिस इज सम ऑफ द कॉमन थिंग्स जो कि आपको डेली बेसिस पे ध्यान रखनी पड़ेगी. तो आई हैव जस्ट लिस्टेड दीज थिंग्स लाइक डेटा थेफ्ट. अ सोशल नेटवर्किंग साइट इज एन इन्फॉर्मेशन रिपोजिटरी एक्सेस बाय मेनी यूजर्स and enhancing the risk of information exploitation. Okay, आपकी बहुत सारी ऐसी information है जो कि यहाँ से निकाली जा सकती है. Okay, so you have to be very restrictive while sharing. लोग क्या करते हैं, कहीं भी move on कर रहे हैं, कहीं जा रहे हैं, they just, आज सुबह मैंने ये किया, so I just tagged this particular place. Okay, so you are just giving all your particular geolocation, which is not a very good thing. Okay, so but people usually do that, so you have to be very careful what to share and what not to share. So you have to be very precise about that. Involuntary data leakage, okay, aapka unknowingly koi ek post thi, wo ki sensitive data tha, wo aapne kiya post, ho sakta hai usko kis tarah se use kar rakha hai, but achhi networking sites pe, social networking sites pe, they have a very strong policy, they usually check what kind of information you are posting in. Okay, so aajkal aisa bhi hai, Facebook usually do it. Targeted attacks, attackers use the information basically available on these platforms. We have discussed about that. And network vulnerability, obviously we told like there is a kind of like flaws and bugs as well, which can cause vulnerabilities in the organization's network. Okay, jo aap networking site use kar rahe ho, ho sakta hai ki usme hi koi vulnerability ho, and they may easily lead to some of the compromises in your corporate networks as well. Okay, so you have to be very peculiar about using these particular applications when you are in the organizational network. Okay, so aapko aware hona zyada zaruri hai. Okay, so that is the main thing that I just want to tell in this particular slide. Okay, so I think so pretty much clear. So this is another thing that we want to discuss related to social engineering. This is identity theft statistics. Okay, so this is very old data, but it has might have been changed a lot. Okay, but what is identity theft? I can just tell you. This do not go on to this particular data. I will be going on to the basic introduction. What it is identity theft is, and काफी लोगों को पता भी होगा. So it is basically what you call as stealing the identification information of someone. Okay, and identity theft is popularly what you call as used for frauds. उसको frauds के लिए use किया जाता है. And anyone with malicious intent may steal your identification by gathering documents such as what you call as utility bills, personal information, and other what you call as relevant information, and create a new ID card. Okay, to impersonate someone. So this is your identity theft. आपकी कोई बहुत जरूरी personal information चुराई गई, ताकि जैसे आपका नाम, आपका ID number, okay, whatever is the driving license, something. You have some information on the utility bill, usko chura liya gaya aur usko use kar rahe hain. So this is your particular identity theft. Your identity is your particular traits, your characteristics, your personal information. Okay, so this is what is happening these days. Okay, aapke paas bills aate hain, aapke paas power bills hain, aapka water bill hai, electricity bill hai, so people usually what they do, they just throw into the dustbin. Okay, they can be usually recollected and some information can be easily gathered. Okay, so it is not all about an ID card. He or she may use this information to particularly fake, to make a fake identity and take advantage of it. Okay, so ye bahut ho raha hai identity theft. And process basically iska kya rehta hai, ki identity theft process starts with the initial phase jo maine aapko kal bataya tha, in which the attacker is focused on finding all necessary beneficial information including personal and professional information. Okay, जिसमें मैंने आपको बताया था एक term dumpster diving, and by access the desk of an employee is very effective technique. Okay, so dumpster diving मतलब आपके आसपास जहाँ पे आपने litter किया, जहाँ पे आपने चीजों को फेंका है, so obviously people usually recollect that. And however, social engineering also works. Okay, the attacker will find the utility bill, आपका ID cards, आपके documents, which will be helpful to get a fake ID card. Okay, for an authorized issuing source such as your driving license often. इतना सारा कुछ collect कर लिया है ताकि एक नया ID card बनाया जा सके. Okay, just which will have your information because you're authorized for that particular organization. लेकिन वो कोई और बना रहा है आपके लिए. Okay, so this is the identity theft. Okay, so this usually happens. So that is what I've listed in this slide as well. So this basically someone steals your information. Okay, and it is basically a crime, and he or she tries to be an imposter. Okay, imposter का मतलब है आपकी information चुरा के fake ID बना के आपकी organization में enter कर सकता है. Okay, या फिर बहुत सारी चीजें use की जा सकती हैं. Okay, मैंने आपका fake driving license बना लिया. Okay, I can go to the bank and somewhere say for example and I can say I have this particular ID और मेरा कुछ खो चुका है, तो please use this as my ID and give me a new card. Okay, और अगर कहीं पे कोई चीज सही से चेक नहीं करी, so obviously there is a particular loophole in this. So try to be very aware. Okay, so social engineering ऐसा है कि आपके पास कोई एक antivirus नहीं है, कोई भी आपके पास ऐसा software नहीं है जो कि So now, what are the countermeasures? किसी तरह से अगर say for example इनको कहीं पर रोका जा सके, okay? So we can have some discussion related to this. What are the social engineering countermeasures? Okay, how these things can be mitigated? Okay, so but still you do not have a perfect tool. You have to be very careful and aware. But still, like what you call as privacy in the corporate environment is very necessary. Okay, बहुत सारी organizations में आप काम कर रहे होंगे, बहुत सारे वहाँ पे rules हैं, बहुत सारे regulations हैं, आपके पास authorizations हैं, access controls हैं, firewall settings हैं, whatever or something else also. But still, privacy in the corporate environment is necessary to mitigate shoulder surfing and dumpster diving threats. Okay, पहले तो ये बहुत common चीजें होती हैं, ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए. Okay, तभी आप देख रहे होंगे shoulder surfing means you should be having an isolated cabin or a cubicle to work upon so that nobody can peep into that. Okay, aapko jhaank ke aapke system se koi information aapke bina jankari ke na li ja sake. Okay, next is you should configuring strong password, securing the passwords, keeping them secrets will protect against social engineering. Okay, passwords bahut normal nahi, just follow a common pattern. Okay, मैंने यूजुअली आई हैव एनकाउंटर्ड दैट पीपल हैव सेम पासवर्ड्स ओके फॉर एवरी अकाउंट स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम देयर जीमेल टू देयर बैंक अकाउंट्स एज वेल दे हैव अ सिंगल पासवर्ड इफ वन एनी हाउ वन ऑफ द अकाउंट गेट कॉम्प्रोमाइज ऑब्वियसली आपके बाकी अकाउंट्स पे भी खतरा है ओके तो थोड़ा सा आपको इसके लिए अवेयर रहना होगा दिस शुड नॉट हैपन ओके सोशल नेटवर्किंग इज ऑलवेज अ रिस्क इन्फॉर्मेशन लीकेज एक ऐसा लूप होल हो सकता है कि जहां से आपकी बहुत सारी precise information जो कि leak हो सकती है, so try to be very selective in sharing your information on these social media platform. But now social engineering is also becoming an important platform for an organization to use. Okay, अब बहुत सारी organizations भी इसको साथ साथ use कर रही हैं. But still we can say keep monitoring the social networking platforms. ठीक है, their logging information. There is a very huge requirement of training and awareness. Also, what you can call as an audit can effectively reduce the risk of social engineering attacks. Okay. So I have listed some of the things over here as well, not on that slide. So like password policies, what we are talking about, like periodic password change hona chahiye. कई लोग छः-छः महीने नहीं करते, but अच्छी websites और अच्छी organizations में अब एक महीने के बाद या पंद्रह दिन के बाद आपको pop up आता है that you have to change your particular password. So keep on changing that. That is a very good habit, and do not keep your password exactly as same as for every website. Okay, and also do not write and keep it somewhere. Okay, कई लोग लिख के अपना ATM pin कहीं रख लेते हैं. I do not know why are they doing so. Avoid guessable passwords. कॉमन पासवर्ड्स की एक आपको लिस्ट मिल जाएगी इफ यू गूगल, आपका कॉमन पासवर्ड उसमें नहीं होना चाहिए. ओके लाइक पीपल डू व्हाट इज क्यूआरटी, दिस इज QWERTY, ओके देयर नेम @123, देयर डेट ऑफ बर्थ, देयर फोन नंबर, सो डू नॉट ट्राई टू दिस, अवॉइड दिस. And I know many of the participants are following these policies. Okay. Account blocking after failed attempts. So there must be a kind of thing like if you are just making a fake attempt like 1, 2, 3, that particular thing should get blocked. Okay. And only the admin on a request can just unblock that. So this kind of policy must be implemented in that organization. Length and complexity of passwords, I've told you, 8 to 16. Secrecy of password, you should not write, keep it encrypted in some of the file. Whatever you want to do. Physical security policies bhi aapke paas bahut saari hain. Like what you call is issuing an identification numbers or the ID cards. Every organization follows these days. Escorting the visitors. Koi aapki organization mein third person aata hai, toh obviously you have to be tracking his or her detail. Okay. You should just have a particular information. Ki agar track back karna pada, toh you have all the information. Okay. So ye common policies hain. Access area restrictions. Jahan pe bahut zyada confidential काम है, so you have to be have very restricted and prohibited area, okay? और काफी organizations में है, and other organizations should follow if they want to be secure enough. Proper shredding of useless documents, okay? Documents लोग के पास जब जरूरत नहीं होती, they just basically tear them off and put into the dustbin, okay? So do not do that. There अलग से machines आती हैं, you can just litter them off. They will be cutting into pieces, they can be reusable, okay? ताकि कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन उससे ना ली जा सके. एंड इट यूजुअली हैपन, ओके, वो कुछ पास्ट इवेंट्स ऐसे हैं जिसमें से श्रेड डॉक्यूमेंट्स और यूजलेस डॉक्यूमेंट्स का यूज किया गया. ओके, पीपल यूजुअली व्हाट दे डू, कहीं पे आपको कहा जाता है कि से फॉर एग्जांपल अपना आधार कार्ड पैन कार्ड की फोटोकॉपी जमा करी. ओके, सो बी वेरी स्पेसिफिक कि कहाँ जमा कर रहे हैं. अगर वो यूज हो रहा है तो यू जस्ट पुट अ पर्टिकुलर सेल्फ अटेस्टेड साइन, ऐसे ही किसी को भी कॉपी मत दें, ही और शी कैन यूज इट somewhere else as well. Okay. So these are other countermeasures that we talked, like training. Okay. Awareness की बहुत कमी है, तो training programs होते रहने चाहिए. Okay. Training से ज़्यादा important है कि आप खुद self introspective होइए. मतलब आप अपने से question करिए. Okay. Because if you get into the Facebook security privacy policy panel, आप उसमें ही देख लेंगे कि वहाँ पे बहुत सारी ऐसी policies हैं जो कि आपने apply ही नहीं करी हैं अपने account के लिए. जैसे एन एग्जाम्पल, ओके, तो आप टू फैक्टर ऑथेंटिकेशन लगा सकते हैं, लॉगिंग इन्फॉर्मेशन देख सकते हैं. ओके, अगर आपने ये एक्टिवेट नहीं किया है तो आपको करना चाहिए. सो दिस इज सम ऑफ द काइंड ऑफ अवेयरनेस जो आपको खुद से आएगी. ओके, कीप ऑन चेंजिंग द पासवर्ड, समथिंग लाइक दिस. ऑपरेशनल गाइडलाइंस बहुत सारे लोग फॉलो अप करते हैं, ठीक है, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन भी देती हैं. ओके, बट आपको इंश्योर करना है कि सेंसिटिव इन्फॉर्मेशन आपकी सिक्योर रहे. ओके, एक्सेस प्रिविलेजेस मीन्स so there must be a kind of a administrator who should give permission to a concerned person into the department, jiske liye wo department hai wahi khali us information ko access kare, sabke sab access nahi karenge. So there should be a kind of a hierarchical system. Ek administrator hai, there are different users, aur ek user dusre user ke area mein intersect nahi karega. Okay, so this is what access privileges. If you get into the much detail, so there is access privilege rights control. Okay, so pura ek uspe syllabus bhi hai. Classification of information is very much important. You have to categorize the information ki kaun sabse zyada secretive hai, kaun confidential hai, kisko public karna hai, kisko nahi karna hai. So you have a very classified information. If you have worked upon some of the object oriented programming languages, so we have access specifiers over there like public, private, protected. So this is something related to that logic. Okay. Proper incidence response time. Okay. There should be the entire monitoring. Now big organizations are having SOCs. Okay. Security Operations Center, which basically monitors each and every kind of thing that is happening in their particular network or the premises. सारा कुछ monitor करते हैं. Okay. कुछ भी कहीं पे हो रहा है तो they get just a kind of a pop-up or a डायलॉग कि हाँ ये हुआ. उसके लिए बहुत सारे टूल्स हैं, लाइक व्हाट वी कॉल एज आईपीएस, लाइक प्रिवेंशन सिस्टम्स आर देयर, इंट्रूजन प्रिवेंशन डिवाइसेस, डिटेक्शन डिवाइसेस. ओके, वी हैव हनी पॉट्स, व्हाटएवर. ओके, सो यू हैव टू मॉनिटर, कंटिन्यूअसली मॉनिटरिंग योर सिस्टम. ओके, एंड इन केस कहीं पे कुछ आपको एनोमलस बिहेवियर लगता है, कुछ एनोमली आती है, तो आपको एक पर्टिकुलर रिस्पॉन्स आना चाहिए. ओके, ऐसा नहीं हो कि हो चुका और फिर आए. बैकग्राउंड चेक एंड प्रॉपर टर्मिनेशन. प्रोसेस ओके। सो ये आपको चेक करना होगा कि आपके, जैसे मैंने अभी थोड़ी देर पहले बताया इनसाइडर अटैक्स के बारे में, सो इनसाइडर अटैक्स के लिए भी आपको कई ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस में उनको मॉनिटर करते हैं, और अगर आपके पास कुछ क्रिमिनल बैकग्राउंड्स हैं या बैकग्राउंड्स आपके ठीक नहीं है तो दे शुड नॉट बी हायर्ड और उनको टर्मिनेट करना चाहिए। तो दिस इज जस्ट अ वेरी कॉमन काउंटर मेजर विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैव स्टार्टेड मेकिंग दीज डेज। ओके, सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। ओके, सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द काउंटर मेजर्स रिलेटेड टू सोशल इंजीनियरिंग, सो यू मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट। सो दीज आर मोर और लेस रिलेटेड टू द व्हाट यू कॉल एज अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम्स। There are some other things that I have written, so I can just quickly tell you. This is not very technical, but people apply that, like antivirus, anti-phishing defenses. I told you, okay. Multiple layers में अलग-अलग जगह पे gateway levels पे आपको इनको incorporate करना चाहिए. People have IDS system. There can be host-based IDS system. That's IDS means intrusion detection systems. There is network-based intrusion detection systems. Okay. जो कि हर एक लेवल पे आपको बताएंगे कि हाँ आप यहाँ पे ऐसा ऐसा हो रहा है, दिस इज अ मॉनिटरिंग काइंड ऑफ अ सिस्टम, ताकि सोशल इंजीनियरिंग अटैक्स को थोड़ा कम किया जा सके। वी कैन मिनिमाइज देम बाय यूजिंग दीज काइंड ऑफ डिफेंस सिस्टम्स। ओके, देयर इज बेसिकली अ काइंड ऑफ टू फैक्टर ऑथेंटिकेशन। ओके, टू फैक्टर ऑथेंटिकेशन बेसिकली आप व्हाट यू कॉल एज लेवल्स को अप कर रहे हैं। Okay, instead of using some of the fixed passwords, aaj ki date pe two-factor authentication hai. Like you receive an OTP, okay, you receive half OTP on your mobile, half OTP last digits on your particular email. Then you have to combine them and place them. So aaj kal aisa bhi ho raha hai. You get a particular link on your email, then you will be redirected to that site. So this is a proper thing to do for two-factor authentication. Taki jo ye kar raha hai, hum usko khali authenticate. कर पाए कि वो जेन्युइन यूजर है या फिर नहीं है। दिस इज व्हाट इज कॉमन। चेंज मैनेजमेंट, ऑब्वियसली अ डॉक्यूमेंट चेंज मैनेजमेंट शुड बी देयर। डॉक्यूमेंट चेंज मैनेजमेंट का मतलब है दिस इज पर्टिकुलरली मोर सिक्योर एज कंपेयर टू द प्रोसेस व्हिच बेसिकली फॉलोड लाइक फाइल मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम होता था। ठीक है, तो वो वैसे ही चलता है, बट ऑन यूजुअली बेसिस वी शुड कीप ऑन चेंजिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर फाइल मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। ओके, सो These are some of the countermeasures what we can take actually to basically हम पूरी तरह से खत्म नहीं कर सकते।
Excuse me, Mr. Nand, sorry to interrupt you.
Avoid them. Okay, so revenge better than cure. ये बहुत पुराना एक आपने सुना होगा। So similarly for social engineering attacks as well, हम उनको avoid करने की कोशिश कर सकते हैं by just having pretty much awareness toward these things actually. Okay, बहुत इनसे भी ज़्यादा like sim clonings हैं, sim आपके पास प्रैंक कॉल्स हैं, बहुत सारी चीजें आती हैं। सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी, यू जस्ट 100 टाइम्स बिफोर क्लिकिंग ऑन टू एनी ऑफ द अननोन लिंक दैट यू आर गेटिंग। एक्चुअली आपको 1000 बार सोचना चाहिए, नहीं तो एटलीस्ट 2 बार सोचना चाहिए आप किसी भी लिंक पे क्लिक करने से पहले। आप उसको ध्यान से देखें, आपके पास जो भी मेल आ रही है उसको भी ध्यान से देखें। ओके, विजुअलाइज दैट मेल, सेंडर मेल का है। ओके, क्यों मेल आई है आपके पास, डू नॉट गेट पैनिक। पैनिक करने से कुछ नहीं होगा, यू विल लूज समथिंग। ओके, सो बेटर टू जस्ट हैव अ बिग विजिबिलिटी ओवर दैट ईमेल, उसके बाद आप डिसाइड करें कि क्या करना है। आपको लिंक पे क्लिक करना है, पीडीएफ को खोलना है या नहीं। ओके, गो फॉर लाइक व्हाट यू कॉल एज एंटी वायरस सिस्टम। ओके, यू हैव, इफ यू आर हैविंग विंडोज, यू आर हैविंग द डिफेंडर, उसको ऑन नहीं करते लोग। दिस इज बेसिकली अ यूज दैट आई हैव सीन। तो ये कॉमन कॉमन चीजें हैं जो कि आपको देखनी है। ओके, so this is last slide, like what is what we can call as social engineering pen testing. So I can just give you a few details what researchers are basically doing, because we are more or less related to a academic and research institute. So I can just tell you something related to technicalities of this and what basically researchers are. Somebody's I think so, no, okay. So we'll take some of the doubts if they are. I just finished with this particular thing. Then we'll take the questions as well. So this is something related to what particular researchers are doing. Researchers basically किस तरह से इसको encounter करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। तो we have a few steps जो कि मैंने list किए हैं, but it cannot be very, I cannot go into very much technical. But these are 4 main steps to perform social engineering penetration testing, including test planning. And scoping, attack vector identification, penetration attempts, एंड व्हाट यू कॉल एज रिपोर्टिंग. ओके, तो मैं एक एक पॉइंट को थोड़ा थोड़ा आपको डिस्क्राइब कर देता हूँ ताकि आपके पास एक फिनोमिनन बैकग्राउंड क्रिएट हो जाए. बट इट इज अ वेरी ह्यूज टॉपिक इन इटसेल्फ. लाइक द फर्स्ट स्टेप, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल टेस्ट प्लानिंग एंड स्कोपिंग में क्या है, इन माई ओपिनियन इट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप ड्यूरिंग द पेनिट्रेशन टेस्ट. एंड वॉट हैपन्स ड्यूरिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टेप, यू विल आइडेंटिफाई वॉट इज द स्कोप एंड हाउ द टेस्ट विल बी परफॉर्म्ड. ओके, और करना क्या है आपको, दिस टिपिकली रिक्वायर्स अ मीटिंग लाइक सॉर्ट ऑफ अ थिंग बिटवीन मैनेजमेंट एंड द पर्सनल परफॉर्मिंग द टेस्ट. ओके, आपको मीटिंग्स का राउंड करना पड़ेगा एंड यू हैव टू फाउंड. एंड वन थिंग टू कीप इन माइंड इज दैट यू वॉन्ट टू कीप द नंबर ऑफ पीपल इन्वॉल्व इन दिस मीटिंग टू बी वेरी मिनिमम to prevent the number of people that know about the test. Okay, so somebody is on the chat window. What is the modem pools? Okay, just a minute, sir. I will just get back to your particular question. Okay. I will get back to you what is modem pools. I will just coming to that point as well. So, you want to just what I'm talking about testing, planning and scoping phase. So in this particular phase, one thing to just keep in mind is that I have to keep the number of people as minimum as possible to prevent the number of people that basically know about the test. Okay, ki aap aisa kuch karna ja rahe hain, so total number of people should be as low as possible. And also you want to test, say for example, to be very accurate as possible. Okay, and what else? To do this, you need to minimize the awareness of the test. Okay, कि ऐसा कुछ होने वाला. While scoping out the test, you will want to include all methods and attacks that you plan to use. Okay, for example, like if you want to tailgate or impersonate employees or delivery personnel, that needs to be in the scope. Okay, scoping में आपको सब कुछ cover करना है जिसके ऊपर आप ये particular काम करने जा रहे हैं. Okay, and from the scope, you will be able to write a clear contract that is agreed on by all the parties. Okay, so this, the contract is the key to the penetration. Okay, so this is a kind of testing, planning and scoping what happens actually. And is tarah se isko use karte hain aur people basically the researchers start like this ki suppose humne plan kiya hai and what to test actually with the minimum number of people and they just try to do each and every kind of an attack. Okay, or maximum इन्फॉर्मेशन उससे निकालनी. सिमिलरली जब सेकंड फेज में आप आएंगे तो देयर इज अटैक वेक्टर आइडेंटिफिकेशन. दिस इज आल्सो वेरी टेक्निकल बट स्टिल आई कैन जस्ट टेल यू इन अ शॉर्ट थिंग लाइक दीज मेथड शुड आल्सो बी लिंक्ड टू सर्टेन यूजर एंड ग्रुप्स ओनली. एंड आफ्टर यू हैव स्कोप्ड आउट द पेन टेस्ट यू हैव अ क्लियरली डिफाइंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉर व्हाट एंड व्हाट यू आर अलाउड टू टेस्ट. तो आप टेस्ट क्या करने जा रहे हैं, तो देयर मस्ट बी एन अटैक वेक्टर आइडेंटिफिकेशन सॉर्ट ऑफ अ थिंग. ओके, so listing out the attack vectors like we have did, say for example, you have to just define the scope of the particular problem and you have to hit that particular problem. Okay, so this is your attack vector sort of an identification. Okay, then we have the penetration attempts. Okay, so you have to plan what attempts, like the type of evidences are there. Okay, so you have to document that. You have to just do all these particular things to take all of the listed attack vectors जो आपने last phase में किया है और फिर उसका use करके आपको ये काम करना है. ठीक है, और last में एक report आपको पूरी बनेगी. तो this is the social engineering pen testing, but this is very short जो मैंने आपको बताया. Okay, but these are the major points कि किस तरह से आपका channelize किया जाएगा. Okay, so testing, planning and scoping will be there. क्या करना है, you have to very specific clear strategy about that. Attack vector identification hona chahiye. Okay, what you are planning to do aur kis tarah se karenge. Okay, kon kon se attacks aapko karne hain, kon kon se information aapko dekhni hai, fir attempts mein kya kya hoga wo maine aapko bataya, aur last mein fir hum ek report banate hain. This is a kind of the social engineering pen testing what we have actually. Okay, so these are pretty much common, but these are not very related to the common things, but still you have say for example, agar aap kuch research oriented ya academic oriented kaam karenge, then you will face these as the major things. Okay, so you have to be very specific about that. like what you are calling ki aapko karna kya hai. Strategies must be very clear. So aapko testing, scoping, scope pehle se pura aapko karna padega. Otherwise this will create a problem. Okay, so this is something what you call as feasibility study, jo ki bahut common cheez hai. Okay. And then we move on to the attack vector identification. ये बहुत एक important है. Attack vector किस तरह से आप plan करेंगे, आपको क्या करना है. Okay. Then हम penetration attempts करना start करते हैं. हम tools use कर सकते हैं. There are personalized scripts as well. Okay. और finally जो हमारे पास उसका conclusive statement है, वो हम reporting statements में लेके आएंगे. Okay. So I will get to the another slide and एक छोटा सा demo है, वो मैं आपको दिखा देता हूँ कि किस तरह से मैंने last में note में लिखा है. इस base SETA एक आपके पास सोशल इंजीनियरिंग टूल किट है. दिस इज वेरी कॉमन. अगर पार्टिसिपेंट्स ने देखा होगा तो पहले किया भी होगा. बट दिस इज यूज फॉर पेनिट्रेशन टेस्टिंग अराउंड सोशल इंजीनियरिंग. ओके, इट इज एन ओपन सोर्स पाइथन ड्रिवन टूल. ये काली लिनक्स में प्री इंस्टॉल्ड और आपको पहले से सेल्फ डिफॉल्ट इंस्टॉल्ड मिलेगा. लेकिन एक गिटहब लिंक भी मैं आपसे शेयर कर दूंगा इनकेस यू वॉन्ट टू डाउनलोड एंड सेल्फ ट्राई इट. आप उसको भी कर सकते हो, तो वो भी मैं आपको भी दिखा देता हूँ बाय द एंड. सो अभी किसी ने मेरे से पूछा वॉट इज अ मॉडर्न पूल. So as far as my knowledge is concerned, the modern pool is, I think so, a compact box with, I think so, 8 GSM modules basically. Okay, and that will can be basically be replaced without opening the entire whole device. And each of that particular module, what you call as the GSM module, has basically slots for both, like what you call as a large or a small SIM. Okay, and it is kind of a connection which you basically set up between the external antenna and audio connection or to particularly on and off kind of a switch. Okay, so I think so this is not very much related to what I am talking, but still modem pool ki jitne bare mein main aapko bata sakta tha, it's basically a kind of a compact box aur usme shayad, I hope so, I think so, there is 8 GSM modules. Okay, so basically you can replace that particular thing, okay, by opening the entire whole device or isme ek on and off individual. और सपोर्ट करने के लिए इसमें आप कोई चाहे छोटा या फिर बड़ा, लार्ज एंड स्मॉल बेसिकली सिम्स कैन इजीली बी यूज्ड इन. ओके, सो देयर इज समथिंग सर, वेयर विल यू शेयर द लिंक? ऑब्वियसली आई हैव द होस्ट और द पर्टिकुलर कोऑर्डिनेटर्स और द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर इवेंट विल बी शेयरिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर लिंक. ओके, आई विल जस्ट गिव यू इन द वीडियो ऑफ थिंग्स सो इट इज विल बी क्लियर और आपको लिंक मिल जाएगा. ओके, एनी हाउ आई विल से देम टू शेयर द लिंक. ओके, so just a minute, give me a time. So this is so this is what you call, this is the GitHub link. Okay, so I will share with you. So this will have the entire code, but I will straight away go on to the Linux Kali part, which has this particular pre-installed thing. So I will start from there. So just a minute. See, this is the pre-installed SET that you get basically in the Kali Linux. And over here, if you can see, there is a select from the menu. Okay. तो आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं कि यहाँ पे लिखा है सोशल इंजीनियरिंग अटैक्स, देयर इज पेनिट्रेशन टेस्टिंग, थर्ड पार्टी मॉड्यूल्स, अपडेट द सोशल इंजीनियरिंग टूलकिट्स एंड देयर आर टू मेनी अदर ऑप्शंस. ओके, सो आज के लिए जैसे हम सोशल इंजीनियरिंग अटैक्स के लिए काम कर रहे हैं, तो SET में जब आप क्लिक करोगे, तो जब आप Kali Linux आपके पास अगर इंस्टॉल्ड हो, दिस इज वेरी सिंपल थिंग टू डू. ओके, तो जैसे ही आप SET पे क्लिक करेंगे, सो यू विल बी हैविंग दिस काइंड ऑफ अ कंसोल. ओके, और यू हैव टू जस्ट सिलेक्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर ऑप्शन वन, क्योंकि हम सोशल इंजीनियरिंग अटैक्स पे बात कर रहे हैं. तो आप जैसे वन सेलेक्ट करोगे, सो यू विल एंटर इनटू अनदर मेन्यू. ओके, सो जैसे ही से फॉर एग्जांपल वी क्लिक्ड ऑन टू दिस सोशल इंजीनियरिंग अटैक्स, सो वी सेलेक्ट द ऑप्शन फर्स्ट. आपको खाली वन टाइप करना है और एंटर प्रेस करना है. अब जैसे आप आगे बढ़ेंगे, तो यहाँ पे देखिए आपका मेन्यू और भी आगे आएगा. ओके, मतलब उसके अंदर भी सब कैटेगरीज हैं, स्पीयर फिशिंग अटैक वेक्टर्स, वेबसाइट अटैक वेक्टर्स, इन्फेक्शनियस मीडिया जनरेटर एंड व्हाट नॉट. ओके, सो इसमें से भी आपको जैसे सपोज वेबसाइट टैग वेक्टर्स के लिए है तो आपको वो चूज करना पड़ेगा. ओके यानी सपोज सेकंड ऑप्शन अगर आपने चूज किया तो यू हैव टू टाइप टू एंड प्रेस एंटर. ओके तो जैसे आप एंटर प्रेस करेंगे तो यू विल मूव ऑन फर्दर. ओके आप आगे मूव करोगे तो आपके पास फिर से एक मेन्यू आएगा जैसे आपको नीचे दिख रहा है 1, 2, 3 से लेके. तो अब इसमें हमें क्या करना है, हमें क्रेडेंशियल्स से फॉर एग्जांपल निकालने हैं किसी वेबसाइट से, हम इम्पर्सोनेट करेंगे और हम वेबसाइट से डेटा निकालेंगे. सो हमारे लिए थर्ड ऑप्शन विल बी दी बेस्ट वन फॉर दिस एग्जांपल. हमें 3 टाइप करना है और एंटर प्रेस करना है लाइक क्रेडेंशियल हार्वेस्टर अटैक मेथड. तो ये आप करके देख सकते हैं, लिंक मैं शेयर करूंगा और लिनक्स आप इंस्टॉल कर लीजिएगा तो दिस इज वेरी कॉमन एंड आपको खाली वीडियो फॉलो करना है. तो थर्ड वाला हमारे यूज का है अभी के लिए एग्जाम्पल में, बाकी आप बहुत सारी चीजें कर सकते हो, हम सारे मैंने नहीं दिखाए हैं इसमें. तो देयर इज क्रेडेंशियल हार्वेस्टर अटैक मेथड, क्रेडेंशियल्स निकालने की बात हो रही है. ओके सो देयर इज 1, 2, 3 वेब टेम्पलेट साइट क्लोनर कस्टम इम्पोर्ट. अब आप क्रेडेंशियल्स निकालने कैसे जा रहे हो, ठीक है, तो आपको साइट को क्लोन करना है. तो देयर इज अ सेकंड ऑप्शन, तो अगेन यू हैव टू टाइप टू एंड प्रेस एंटर. साइट कौन सी क्लोन करनी है वो भी आपको बताना पड़ेगा, तो वो भी आपको कुछ बाय डिफॉल्ट है और कुछ अदरवाइज आपको बतानी है. तो यहाँ पे एक चीज देखिए सॉरी यहाँ पे नीचे लिखा आईपी एड्रेस फॉर द पोस्ट ब्लॉक बैक इन द हार्वेस्टर. मतलब आप जो भी क्लोन करोगे तो ऑब्वियसली इट विल बी सेविंग इनटू अ फोल्डर वैर डब डब डब. ओके सो ये उसकी आपके पास पर्टिकुलर आईपी एड्रेस है, दैट इज 192, जो कि आपको अपने ब्राउजर पे पिंग करनी होगी. ब्राउजर पे जब आप टाइप करेंगे तो आपकी फेक एप्लीकेशन खुल के आएगी. अभी हम दिखाते हैं, तो यही आईपी मेरे को यूज करनी है, आपके सिस्टम पे कुछ और हो सकती है. सो एज वी मूव ऑन इन द वीडियो अभी, ठीक है, सो देखिए यहाँ पे आपके पास कुछ वेबसाइट्स ऑलरेडी दी गई, ठीक है, कि किसको आप क्लोन करना चाहते हैं. तो से फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट अ टेम्पलेट. तो बाय डिफॉल्ट आई एम सेलेक्टिंग सपोज गूगल के लिए करना है मेरे को. तो यहाँ पे आप देखिए क्लोनिंग दी वेबसाइट, इसमें लिखा है ना आई हैव सेलेक्टेड दी टेम्पलेट टू, यानी टेम्पलेट टू है. तो टू टेम्पलेट कौन सा था, गूगल का. आप कुछ और देना चाहते थे तो आप वहाँ पे टाइप भी कर सकते हो https ओके एंड व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस साइट. तो यहाँ पे वो क्लोन करना स्टार्ट कर रहा है किसको, गूगल के पेज को. देखिएगा कुछ आपको कैसा दिखाई देगा जब क्लोनिंग हो चुकी होगी. आपको ब्राउजर पे जाना है, तो विल गो टू द ब्राउजर इन दिस वीडियो, जस्ट हैव अ लिटिल पेशेंस, अभी आपको देखने को मिलेगा. तो वी हैव द आईपी एड्रेस, आईपी एड्रेस आपको याद रखना होगा. तो वही आईपी एड्रेस इसके करस्पॉन्डिंग आपको डालना है, तो आपको एक फेक पेज या फेक वेबसाइट मिलेगी. ओके फिर क्रेडेंशियल्स कहाँ पे दिखाई देंगे, तो आपके लिए इस टर्मिनल को आपको बंद नहीं करना है. तो कहाँ पे आएगा वो भी मैं अभी आपको बताता हूँ. So we go on to the new tab. Okay. So यहाँ पे आपने वही IP address type करना, that is 192.168.30.129, जो कि वहाँ पे flash हुआ था. जब आप click करेंगे तो देखिए this is a fake page. Okay. But this appears exactly like what you call as your particular Google sign-in page. Okay. Everything is pretty much common. और अगर इस तरह से किसी के पास जाता है, ठीक है, तो आप सपोज कर लिए किसी ने अपना क्रेडेंशियल्स इसमें भरा, लाइक से फॉर एग्जांपल वी आर हैविंग सम क्रेडेंशियल्स लाइक संजय साइबर गीक एट द रिस्ट एंड पासवर्ड कुछ भी दिया. जब आप साइन इन करेंगे तो ऑटोमेटिकली इट विल रीडायरेक्ट टू यू. ओके आपको एक्चुअल पेज पे रीडायरेक्ट कर दिया जाएगा. देखिए आप जैसे ही साइन इन करते हैं और अगर आप एड्रेस बार में ऊपर देखेंगे तो आपके पास एग्जैक्टली आप google.com जो कि उसकी एक्चुअल वाले है उस पे जाएंगे. ओके लेकिन अब आप देखिए आपने जो क्रेडेंशियल्स डाले हैं वो आपको कहाँ पे फ्लैश होंगे, यहाँ पे देखिए आप ध्यान से देखेंगे रेड में नीचे में आपके पास लिखा है पॉसिबल यूजर नेम फील्ड फाउंड, ईमेल में आपने क्या डाला था संजय साइबर गीक एट द रेट gmail.com और पासवर्ड फील्ड भी आपके सामने क्लिक होके आएगी वॉट एवर पासवर्ड वी हैव एंटर्ड ओवर हियर. ओके सो इस तरह से जो फेक पेज या फेक आपके पास बना था दैट में have your particular credentials, so गलती से जो भी credentials वहाँ पे डाले गए हैं that is basically coming on to this. So an attacker can very much well planned it, use some kind of these tools, they can write automated scripts to just eventually get this kind of information. Okay, so this is a very normal thing. Okay, normal in the sense, normal example, but these things basically may happen. But आपको बहुत deep dive जाना होगा, you have to learn each and every concept deeply, then only you can just get this kind of an information. Okay, so this is common actually. But aise bahut sare tools, applications available hain GitHub pe as an open source, but you have to use it. I will share the link ki agar aapko download karna hai aur use karna hai, otherwise you can install this particular operating system and can take a feel. Aur usme maine bahut sare options aapko dikhaye, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you can just read about them and can use them. Okay, social engineering attacks ke liye hi hain wo specifically. Okay, so last but not least, I will say you have to be pretty much aware about these things. Okay, आप सब चीजों को यूज करें. सिक्योरिटी aspects के केस में social engineering attacks आपको सिर्फ awareness और आपकी जितनी भी आप common चीजें हैं उनको ध्यान में रखेंगे तभी आपको बचाया जा सकता है. There is no particular tool or framework or anything जो कि आपको इससे save करे. Okay. So I think so I will end up with this session. Or now if you have something to ask you can, and then I will be just ending this.
सर एक बार आप वापस बता दोगे सर अपन ने कैसे यूज किया इसको टेम्पलेट को और इसको. सर एक्चुअली माय कनेक्शन वाज लॉस्ट तो आई कैन नॉट हियर इट.
आई कैन नॉट हियर एनीवन. इफ यू आर यू कैन जस्ट टाइप मी सो दैट. If you have any question, you can just type. Can you tell us again about the template? Which template you are talking about? I didn't get you. Site cloning template is basically, say for example, if you go back into this video, if you are talking about this, so templates are basically say, आपको कौन सी website say for example clone करनी. Okay, so टेम्पलेट्स के अकॉर्डिंग मतलब वहां पे कुछ बाय डिफॉल्ट टेम्पलेट्स हैं आपके पास. ओके, टेम्पलेट इज बेसिकली द काइंड ऑफ अ वेब बेस्ड एप्लीकेशन अगर आपके पास है तो किस तरह से आप उसको बेसिकली क्लोन कर रहे हो. ओके, तो कुछ टेम्पलेट्स आपके पास बाय डिफॉल्ट हैं, कुछ आपको हो सकता है यूज कर सकते हो, कुछ एग्जैक्टली एग्जिस्ट करते हैं. तो टेम्पलेट्स बेसिकली उसका ये मतलब है यहाँ पे. ठीक है, और जब आप इसको थोड़ा सा एक्सप्लोर करोगे देन यू विल सी देयर यूजुअल सम टेम्पलेट्स ओवर देयर इन दैट पर्टिकुलर फोल्डर अवेलेबल. ओके, तो टेम्पलेट्स इसलिए है साइट क्लोन करने के लिए. अगर आपको फिक्स कोई टेम्पलेट चाहिए या इसका जैसा टेम्पलेट चाहिए से फॉर एग्जांपल, तो वो टेम्पलेट की बात हुई वहां पे. ठीक है, बाकी मैं आपको वीडियो भी दे दूंगा और लिंक्स भी हैं, आप एक बार इंस्टॉल करके एक बार इसको देख सकते हैं. एंड उसके बाद भी कोई प्रॉब्लम होगी तो ऑब्वियसली यू कैन जस्ट मेल मी अप. ओके, I think so. Nobody is asking anything. Yes. The EH08 is sir. We have searched our IP address. Okay. I didn't get search. So we searched our IP address. Okay, so what do you want to do after searching your IP address? You're asking me how to search the IP address? But if you want to search anything else and redirect. Okay. I haven't searched about the IP address in this particular demo. मैंने कहीं पे IP address को search नहीं किया. Okay, IP address जो भी था वो obviously मेरे को machine ने मेरे को जो भी दिया that is 192, obviously that is kind of a low, उसको मैंने use किया. Okay, but if we want to search anything else and redirect, what kind of thing you want to search and redirect to? I didn't get actually. If you can unmute yourself and can just put it on voice, अगर आप बोल सकते हैं तो that will be very much clear to me.
Sir, am I audible? Hello, sir.
Sorry, I didn't get the question actually. EH08, whosoever is the participant. अगर तब भी मैं आप सकता हूँ कि मतलब मैंने कोई आईपी एड्रेस को सर्च नहीं किया, ओके, तो व्हाट एवर वी हैव डन बेसिकली द आईपी एड्रेस इज गिवन बाय से फॉर एग्जांपल दैट पर्टिकुलर मशीन, एंड जो लास्ट स्टेटमेंट आपने लिखी है वी वॉन्ट टू सर्च एनीथिंग एल्स एंड रीडायरेक्ट, ओके, सॉरी आई एम नॉट द होस्ट एट दिस पर्टिकुलर टाइम, ओके, सो समबडी एल्स द ऑर्गेनाइजर इज controlling this particular thing, so this is in my control actually.
Let me see. Hello sir. Hello sir.
You can just mail me your particular question. I will ask for the corresponding participant EH08 is asking to me because I am not handling this particular Zoom. Somebody at the background is doing so. Okay. So I will ask them to forward your particular question to me and I will individually email you. Okay, मैं ऐसा कर दूंगा आपके लिए. But अगर आप ऐसा कुछ पूछ रहे हैं कि आप क्या सर्च करना चाहेंगे या कुछ और चीज आपको चाहिए यूजर नेम सॉरी ईमेल और पासवर्ड के अलावा, अगर आपको ऐसा कुछ है तो देर आर अदर टूल्स एज वेल. ओके, आप बहुत सारे ऐसे टूल्स हैं जो कि आप यूज कर सकते हैं. ओके, विच कम्स अंडर दी सेक्शन. Wait on 1 minute, okay. So the credential harvester used here is a CT is a part of this in Lali or it is different from it is the same that is in Kali. And I prefer to use it as in what you do in the Kali Linux, okay. And also I can just want to say that agar aap kuch aur bhi extract karna chahte hain, say for examples, and there are other options available in this particular thing. Aap khali email password nahi, agar aapko bahut sare VAPT tools aapko milenge jisme aap aur bhi sari cheezon ko extract kar sakte hain, okay, but you have to have a specific idea uska background kya hai, tab aapko kya extract karna hai, depending on that you can do this. So जहां तक ये है कि सर द क्रेडेंशियल हार्वेस्टर यूज्ड हियर इज एसईटी, यस इट इज द एसईटी दैट स्पेसिफिकली इन द काली लिनक्स. सर इफ आई वांट टू सर्च एनीथिंग एंड गॉट हिम रीडायरेक्टेड टू आवर फेक टू गेट क्रेडेंशियल्स, सर इफ वांट यूजर टू सर्च एनीथिंग एंड गो हिम रीडायरेक्टेड टू आवर फेक वेबसाइट टू गेट व्हाट शुड बी डू, ओके. You're asking me about कि अगर आपको कुछ ऐसा सर्च आपको रीडायरेक्ट करना है किसी पर्टिकुलर अटैकर को, ओके, तो दिस इज समथिंग यू कैन जस्ट प्राइवेटली ईमेल टू मी, देन ओनली आई कैन डिस्कस ओवर, बट इंडिविजुअली यहाँ पे नहीं कर सकता, दिस इज समथिंग एल्स, ओके. सो आई विल आस्क, आई हैव नोटेड डाउन योर पर्टिकुलर नंबर दैट इज EH08, आई विल आस्क द ऑर्गेनाइजर कि आपको कुछ डाउट है, आई विल जस्ट आंसर दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग, ओके. Okay, so I think so there is no other question, and so thank you very much. Okay, thanks for this particular session. Have a good day. Okay.